Okay, so this video is regarding mealtime supervision, which, believe it or not, is actually one of the most important things that you have to get right. And I've made some notes here of the procedure, but I want you guys to understand when there's an assessment or when the state comes in, one of the single most important things that they're going to look at is that you are following the procedures for mealtime supervision properly. So I just want to cover a few steps here, and I want to make sure that you memorize this because this is definitely one of the most important things. So number one, you really need to make sure that the tables are cleaned and sanitized. First with soap and then with your bleach solution that is made every single morning. You leave the bleach solution on the table for 15 seconds. I don't know why it's 15 seconds, but that's the rules, 15 seconds. Next, wipe each table with separate paper towels and just make sure that there is no cross-contamination. Okay, number two, all children must wash their hands thoroughly before they eat, and all non-food items placed on the table before sitting down at the table. So you wanna make sure that everything is placed on the table, and you wanna make sure that every child washes their hands before they eat. If they don't, that is cross-contamination. That is a gigantic violation. And just as a side note, make sure that you know that food can't be placed on the table more than 15 minutes before mealtime. It has to be less than 15 minutes, which I think is actually an obvious thing. There's no reason to do that. Next, you've got to make sure that all of your materials are out before sitting down. If you have a co-teacher, if you're in a classroom with more than one teacher must be sitting down at all times facing the children. So this is super important because even if one child is sitting down at the table, one of the teachers must be sitting down facing that child. If even one child is eating, you can't get up and sweep and walk around the classroom. As long as even one child is sitting at that table, the teacher has to be sitting down facing the children because it's a huge violation for choking. There's a lot of things that could happen, and you want to take the necessary precautions. The supervising meal teacher should not be performing any other task other than monitoring the children at mealtime. This is important. This is not the time to be on the phone. This is not the time to be cleaning. When children are eating, at least one of the teachers must be sitting there, and that is their sole job function at that moment. Next, make sure you keep an eye out for food not appropriately cut that could be considered a choking hazard. You know, make sure that you look at the plates, make sure that there's no food on there that is too large, that could get lodged in the throats. Make sure that there's adequate liquids available. Make sure that they have their milk or their water or their juice or whatever they're drinking at mealtime. But you want to make sure that as the children are eating, there's nothing large enough that could be a choking hazard. Next, your focus must be on the children. I'm reiterating this because it's really important. You know, as stated in the Gingerbread House handbook, choking is a silent killer. It's literally something that can happen in the blink of an eye. And so if you get nothing else out of this video, mealtime supervision is the most important thing. Once children start to finish their meal, have them sit quietly in their chair until others are completed before you move on to the next task. After mealtime, please make sure tables are cleaned and make sure that all food is swept from below the table. And then finally, instruct children to wash hands before moving on to the next activity. They must wash their hands before, and they must wash their hands after. I hope I did not make this video really, really, really boring. I wanted to get the point across. I wanted to iterate the things that are absolutely critical, but I wanted to kind of do it in at least a little bit of an upbeat attitude. But just understand this, mealtime supervision, all the procedures are in our handbook. They should be in your classroom. And it's so, so, so important that you follow step by step and don't deviate from the process. Thank you.